Hey everyone, it's Tremia, and I'm going to try to make this a quick video because it's not morning. It's actually 10:30 at night. It's been a long day, but they released me from the hospital late this evening, and we actually get a fly home tomorrow. So that's good. For the cultures, were still coming back negative. So they didn't have to take out my port, but they say it takes a full 5 days for the culture to be finalized. And if it does come back positive, they'll be giving me a call back. Don't want a call back. Want it to stay okay. And my liver enzymes, they did start to lower, so I didn't have to do a liver biopsy. I've had one of those in the past, and they're no fun. I did have slight internal bleeding from it, and that I can remember that as not being anything I want to do again. They gave me we went right online. It's Zyvox, I believe, in which it's a last resort medication. And because initially Dr. Burt said he was going to send me home 2 weeks of IV vancomycin, which I'm used to because I've had bacteremia, septicemia, and sepsis in the past, and that's how it was always treated. So I told him that, you know, I was worried about taking this new medication since my body's so sensitive and you know, being away from them. So the plan is I'm going to take it, you know, bright and early, 5, 6 o'clock in the morning. We don't leave our plane doesn't leave till 1. So if something does happen, you know, I'm here and we'll just do what we have to do. And I just hope that medicine, I guess it's the strongest antibiotic out there from what I can tell, so hopefully it'll do its job. I do feel better as far as the blood infection. I can tell now how much that had me worn down, and I think that had a lot to do with how short of breath I was getting. I still am, but you know, I've still got 2 more weeks of that medication. My face is indescribable. The infectious disease doctor is right. It's worse before it's better. It is looking better. I know it is looking better, but it is hurting worse. I just wish it was the other way around. I'd rather be red and no pain, but I've got pain, but it's breaking up. You can tell it's breaking up, and in spots it's turning dark, and I got like these dark spots that I'd never have had before. And so I guess if they don't peel off, I'll see what the dermatologist says to them, because I didn't have them yesterday and they're there today, and so I don't know what's up with that. And I'm supposed to see my rheumatologist as soon as we get back home. So I got to make that appointment with her in the morning. And just continue on. Tomorrow's going to be a long day, but I'll be ready to get home. It's just hard to travel after you've been in the hospital and everything. It's hard to do. But I get to do it. I'm tired, and I need to get me some rest, and so I have a very rare viral infection, and I have staph infection of my blood, so my body's got a little work to do, and then I'll be feeling better, and hopefully this rash, when I wake up in the morning, hopefully it won't be stinging and hurting as badly. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.